Hello everyone, welcome to TechShanmit. In this session, we will discuss about another topic related to COBOL, where we will learn how we can create a para or a paragraph in a COBOL program. If you remember, in our previous session, we discussed the theoretical part of paragraph. We covered each and everything like what is paragraph, what are the rules which we are supposed to follow for creating a paragraph. What are the advantage of paragraphs, right? So these all things we have already discussed. But if you have not covered these topics previously, then firstly I recommend you to go and check out that session first, because if you follow the proper sequence, it would be really very helpful for you, because these are all in a proper sync. Okay, so this entire playlist is connected from each and every session. From top to bottom. So if you follow the entire sequence, then it would be really helpful or a bit easier for you to understand the all concepts. So as I mentioned, that theoretical part we have already covered in our previous session. So now we are just going to focus on the practical thing, and we will increase the complexity step by step. Okay, so in this session we will just see how we can create the para or paragraph in a COBOL program, and once it is clear, then we will move further to understand all concepts related to paragraph. So let's start. So what I will do now, I'll just take option 2 on one of my program which is already created, test PGM1 CBLLE. So taking option 2 here. Now here you can see this is a straightforward syntax I have used so far. Like firstly I have declared one identification division, and identification division is mainly used to inform the author, or you can say it is just to show the program identity related information. For example, here you can see right now program ID is denoting the program name, test PGM1. So this is my program name. Likewise, if we talk about author, then it is indicating author name as Sharmit. So here you can put the name of the author who has created the program, and in program ID you can put the test PGM1 or your program name. Okay, there are other information that we can store here under identification division, which is again related to your program identity. But for now, I'm just using these two information. But as per your requirement, you can make changes there. Okay, fine. So this is regarding the identification division. Now, as I mentioned earlier also, like every topic is already covered related to this prior, means why we kept these line blank. What is the meaning of division, why we are declaring these division, what is procedure division. So these things we have already covered. For now we are just focusing on the para part. Okay, fine. So now once identification division is declared, then you can simply move further forward for other thing. Here you can see we have just declared few comment line, and these comment line are included just to show you the topic name. Okay, so here you can see we have noted down para and COBOL. Remember one thing, whenever you want to declare comment in a COBOL program, always use this seventh position. So you can count from here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. So on seventh place, if you put asterisk, then whatever you will write after that will be considered as a comment line. Again, like if your comment is not coming in white color, no problem, because this is the separate thing that I have implemented here, so no issues. But if you write normally asterisk, and it will be considered as a comment, so don't go with a color. Okay, I'll let you know like how we can change this color, but for now just keep it as it is. Okay, so now after that, what we have kept the procedure division. So these position matters a lot, right? You can see A block, B block. So that's why we have kept everything on a specific position. So just to understand this, you can refer the structure of COBOL program session, which is the first or second session from the COBOL list. Okay, playlist. Okay, so those who are referring all the session, they know that yes, we also declared data division, but in this example we have not kept that. Why? Because here we are not needing the data division, we are not going to declare any variable for the program. Okay, so that's why I just skipped that part and directly started the procedure division. Now what is procedure division? It is the main division, you can say, where you kept all the main logic or the executable codes. Okay, fine. So after writing procedure division, from here we will start writing the para. And at last line number 13, you can see we have mentioned stop run. What it will do, it will just terminate the program once it reaches this line, okay? All right, so let's declare the para. How we can declare the para? So to declare the para, you can simply put any name. For example, I just want to go with para 1. So this is the name of my paragraph, okay? So paragraph, like theoretically we have discussed, just let me explain in a very simpler term. Paragraph is nothing but a label to a set of lines, okay? So suppose we have some set of lines, correlated lines we have stored, right? So all those lines we can assign one name as a label. So whenever we want to redirect our program flow, we can use that label, or you can say paragraph name, okay? So some of you might be aware of CL programming, right? So there we use go to statement with labels, right? So same thing here also. So these are the kind of labels, okay? But there are other things also that we will learn by the time. But for now, you can just assume that this is the paragraph name. Now below to this, whatever I will write will be considered as a lines of code which I want to execute inside this para. So I just write display line 1 inside para 1. Okay, fine. So let's copy it 3 times so that we can put more line here. So before 3, okay, so let's add the line number, change the line number, line 2, line 3, line 4. This is just for the introductory part, okay? So what we have kept so far, we have just assigned one paragraph name, which is para 1, and inside this we have kept these lines, okay? Now to explain in a more simpler way, let's add one more paragraph. So let me copy this entire set from here, we'll put it here, and let's change it to P2, paragraph 2, line 2, let's just change it to, yeah, from here we can change simply 2 to 2, okay? So what it means, like we have declared in this program, we have declared 2 paragraph, okay? Now I want to ask you one question. What will happen, like if I call this program right now, we are not using any perform, go to or move, right? If right now if I run the program, so which line will get executed first? Will it execute this, or will it execute this, or will it go to error, means it will generate error? No, it will not generate error. It will go sequentially, one by one, okay? Firstly it print line this, then this, 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 and likewise it will go for paragraph 2. Okay, let's verify it. So let me compile it and call it. So it is compiled, now calling this. So you can see line 1 inside para 1, para 1, para 1, and line 4. Then line 1 inside para 2, line 2 P2, line 3 P3, line 4 P4. Okay, sorry, para was 2, okay? So we just printed all the lines for both the program. Then some of you might be thinking, like, why we are using then? What is the benefit of using para? Now here, we will talk about perform, although we are going to discuss about this later as well, but let me explain you. Suppose I just want to move or redirect my flow from directly from here to paragraph 2. I don't want to print these lines for a specific condition. So what I can do here, I can simply write here perform and para 2, okay? So what it will do, like if we are not using any redirectional statement like perform, move, go to, then it will go sequentially as it is. But if we are using it, then it will directly move to that part, like perform para 2. Okay, let's see. This time it should print only para 2 lines, not para 1 lines. So you can see line 1 in para 2, line 1, line 2 in para 2, line 3 in para 2, and line 4 in para 2. That means if you are using any redirectional statement, these are redirectional statement, perform, go to, move, right? So in that case it will directly move to that part, not to anywhere else, okay? And don't get confused between these numbers, okay? Instead of this number, whatever you write, for example A, B, C and XYZ, XYZ, okay? And now if let's say I want to move it to XYZ, XYZ. So it is not in a order, numbers are not defining order here, okay? It will just simply work in the same manner. So doesn't matter what you are writing, it will, like, okay, one more thing. Suppose if right now if I move it to ABC para 1, so will it execute the lines after para? Okay, yeah, let's make it again para 1 and para 2, because it will, as per our content, it should show line number. Okay, so let me change it. Okay, so right now if I move my code to para 1, so will it execute these line as well? Let's see. As I mentioned, if we are not using any redirectional statement, it will go in a sequential manner. So you can see 1 1 1 and then 2. Okay, that means it is not checking. Okay, let me check. Then it is showing para 2. Okay, so what we have set inside this code, we just set perform para 1. So what it will go, it will do, it will simply perform this part, and then it will came out again, and then it will follow for this path. And if you go with para 2, then in that case, if I call it again, then it will simply go to para 2 and print all the lines related to para 2, and it will not come back to para 1. Okay, so I hope this part is clear. And in case of para 1, like you have noticed that, I think, let me show you. So if I am running para 1, so what it will do, it will firstly go to para 1, perform para 1, then it will go execute sequential lines, okay, in the same manner, 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10 right now. Okay, so this is how it will work. So like how we are using this COBOL program with para. This is just an introductory session. So in next session we will discuss bit more about redirectional statement. We will understand like what will happen if we are using same kind of iteration with a para. Okay, so these are all things we are going to discuss now. So yeah, that's all for today. In the next session we will discuss few more things. So thank you for watching Tech Sharmit.